Here we go. Let's ride.
Hey, boys, hey, girls. Welcome to Louisiana Cajun Recipe. We're going to make us a meatloaf today. And I may stuff it with cheese. We're going to make a couple veggies. Fresh. Out of the damn can. Maybe some mashed taters. And I don't want to do it out on the grill or the smoker. I found they come out a little dry like that. So I'm just gonna do it in the oven. To keep a meatloaf moist, you really gotta cover it with foil during the first part of the cook. And if you cover it with foil and you got it on a smoker, no smoke gonna get on the meat. And that's what keeps it moist. You take the cover off during the last little bit of cooking. When you're doing it in the oven, if you cook it for an hour, depending on the size of the meatloaf, in the oven covered, then take the cover off, and if you're going to put a tomato sauce on it, add more sauce to it at that point, like let's say ketchup if you like that on it, you would put that on and then let that form a glaze uncovered or crisp up, so to speak, for about 30 minutes uncovered at 350. So we'll get started. And I've wrapped them with bacon and everything before, but and they're good like that. I mean, you could take a stick of boudin and stuff it in the center of it. You could put asparagus in it. You could put boiled eggs peeled. Boiled eggs, boy, through the center of it, and any damn thing you want. And I don't make mine with oatmeal. I just use evap milk and stale bread and bunch of vegetables. Chop up kind of chunky because I just like them like that. Mine's gonna be slightly Italian style. Also, and we're gonna just do that, have some sides with it. Oh, you know what else you could put in it is smoked sausage, but don't get raw and cooked smoked sausage. You got to have a pre-cooked sausage to do that with. And if all you got is raw, then cook it. Go smoke it first, and then put it on the inside, and that works real good too. Whatever kind of meat you're going to put on the inside, it's got to be pre-cooked. A boy, if you're going to do that kind of thing. You put raw vegetables in the center of it. Yum. Let's go. Grandkids are being quiet because I got their attention. Are you paying attention? They don't want to hear nothing about no wooden spoon. That gets their attention quick. Like, I'm paying attention now. Yeah, you better. Grandpa got his wooden spoon. So my super chunky meatloaf got vetoed because the grandkids don't like it. So we got a spin around bowl there with some stale hamburger buns in it. And we're gonna put some evap milk on them and let them soak that up. If you ain't got evap milk, you quit looking at that king cake over there. If you ain't got evap milk, you can just use tomato sauce. So shake the shit out of this. Now, what's your favorite flavor? It's that time of the year for king cake. This one is just cinnamon. I like the chocolate with cream cheese. And the raspberry and the Bavarian and shit, I like them all. Yum. They even got a praline pecan one. And they ship them worldwide if you won't pay for the shipping. Go to GambinosBakery.com. see them people over there. So let me get this open and get this bread wetted. Let it sop up some of that evap milk. Now, I don't like using egg in it, in meatballs or a meatloaf, because it seems to toughen them up some as that egg cooks. So we're going to put some dried oregano's on this. Yeah, a little more. And I'm just going to use some garlic, granulated garlic, actually, even though the bottle says garlic powder, it's not. Yeah, it is, too. I'm sorry. We're going to apply that. And black peppers. Grandkids are being pretty good today. And salts. Gotta have salt. And yeah, my tennis elbow, it's actually drummer's elbow, has been bothering me. So we're gonna apply some salts on here. Okay, top lip. Now I'm gonna put some seasoned blend. I've got one already open in the bowl. You can see that. Now celery, red and green bell peppers, onion, and some parsley. Okay, you see it's frozen too. We need a little more. So that ought to be good. That's probably, I don't know, about 2 cups. Now let's get us some grand beast in there. This is 80-20 ground chuck. Now they fighting. They having a good old time. That's what they do best. We're gonna probably save the rest for something else. And grandkids really getting wild now, so we had to mute the volume. Just mix this up real good. And then we're gonna take a little piece of it and there you go, and stick it in the nuke and check it for seasoning, because we can adjust now if we need to. Either add more bread if it's too salty, or as a little meatball, or more grind meat, or you know, whatever. It's hot.
Yeah, one of those things that I just made is a little bug.
Oh yeah, got him right.
Danny, don't yum. Don't like a microwave.
I'm gonna go ahead and cover this with foil. And I'll bake it, as it say right below. Now, it took it about 1 hour and 15 minutes to get up to 160, and I drained the grease out of it. And you can put anything you want on top of it at this point. You're going to bake it uncovered. Seen some people put barbecue sauce, some people put ketchup mixed with pepper, like black pepper or red pepper or whatever. And that's going to kind of crisp, or not. It's going to thicken up that tomato sauce baked off like that on top. And this came out excellent. And you see the veggies cooked down the way you can't hardly even see them in there. But their flavor is still there. Yum. Some butter beans and carrots and mashed taters. Because the grandkids like all that stuff. So anyway, yep. Yeah, these don't need refrigeration, so they ship well. And you can mail order them. You just got to pay for your ground shipping on them. And they good. Tastes like a big donut. Yum. Every store that's got a deli has king cakes. The donut shop sells them too. There's a chocolate and Bavarian cream and some strawberry and blueberry and strawberry. Yum. Look at the icing dripping off of that. You know, other day I made some hamburger steaks with onions and gravy and biscuits and cream potatoes and some string beans. Yum, yum, yum. If you like what you see on my channel, please subscribe. And y'all have a great and prosperous new year. A boy, a girl, a bye.